Yes, good morning to all of you. Myself Mahesh Jagdish Pingle, lecturer Electronics Engineering, Government Polytechnic Ambad. So dear students, today we are going to discuss the next different terminologies related with your mobile communication. In our previous lecture we discussed about the mobile, then portable terminology, then subscribers, users, mobilers. Then we also discuss the most important one, that is called as the cell, which is always needed in your mobile communication. Now in this particular lecture we are going to discuss the base station system. So what exactly we mean by base station system? So in our previous lecture we discussed that base station, it is always a fixed station. So suppose this is your base station, which is always fixed over the earth. It is not moving part, it is always a fixed part. Your telephone handset, it is a mobile part which is moving always. So base station, it is always fixed, right? Now this particular base station system, so whatever the system implemented in this particular base station, it is called as the base station system. This base station system itself gets divided into two different categories, right? So it consists of a base station controller, right? And base station controller and the base transceiver station. So right, so the base station system consists of base station controller and base transceiver station, right? Now whatever the base transceiver station, it is also known as BTS. It is responsible for all functions related to the radio resources or the channel management, right? So your BTS is responsible for all functions related to radio resource. So it is also known as channel management. So the base transceiver station or BTS, it is related or it is used for all functions related to your channel management, right? Or radio resource management. Now this particular management includes the radio channel configuration with respect to use as speech, data or signal channel, allocation of the channel, release of the channel for a call setup and release. So that's why whatever the things related with your channel selection and communication, it is done with the help of BTS. So this includes a management of radio channel configuration. So first point, so BTS is related with management of radio channel configuration. So whatever the things related with your radio channel and its management, it is done with the help of your BTS. So management of speech, then data. So management of speech, data, और सिग्नलिंग चैनल्स, सिग्नलिंग चैनल्स, देन अलोकेशन एंड रिलीज ऑफ चैनल ऑफ चैनल फॉर कॉल सेटअप, फॉर कॉल सेटअप एंड रिलीज. यस, सो मैनेजमेंट ऑफ स्पीच डेटा सिग्नलिंग चैनल्स, अलोकेशन ऑफ चैनल्स एंड रिलीज ऑफ चैनल्स, राइट. सिमिलरली फॉर कॉल सेटअप एंड रिलीज, इट इज ऑल्सो डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ योर BTS टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम, राइट. सो दिस पर्टिक्युलर BTS, इट इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कंट्रोल ऑफ फ्रिक्वेंसी होपिंग, राइट, एंड ट्रांसमिट पावर एट द ट्रांसमिट पावर एट मोबाइल स्टेशन. सो व्हाट पावर इट शुड बी रिसीव्ड बाय योर मोबाइल स्टेशन, राइट. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट फंक्शंस ऑफ योर बेस स्टेशन सिस्टम. सो आई विल रिकॉल वंस अगेन ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट. सो बेस स्टेशन सिस्टम, इट इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ बेस स्टेशन कंट्रोलर and the base transceiver station. So base transceiver station, it is most important related with the management of channel, right. So whatever the channel you are using for communication between transmission and reception, that channel management itself, it is done with the help of base transceiver station, which is also known, we call it as a BTS, right. So always keep in mind that BTS is responsible for channel management. So what comes under the category of your channel management? So channel management related with speech, data and signaling channels, then allocation and release of channel. So if we want to talk with another person, so which channel we are using, what configuration we are using, it is also decided with the help of your BTS system. Suppose if we are using some internet connections and doing some internet related activities, then allocation of data, it is also done with the help of your BTS. Then signaling between the channels, signaling channels means suppose call making, then release of the call, then shutdown of the call, setup of the call, all these things which is controlled with the help of your BTS system. Then this particular BTS, it is also responsible for control of frequency hopping during this communication process and the transmit power of a mobile station. So what power it should be received by your mobile station. So suppose let us have a look over the concept. So suppose this is your base station, right, and with the help of base station, right, suppose this is your subscriber 1, right, and this particular subscriber wants to talk with the help of this base station to the subscriber 2. So whatever the channel allocation from communication between your subscriber 1 to the subscriber 2, it is done with the help of BTS. So BTS is responsible for the speech communication between subscriber 1 and subscriber 2. So that whole management is done with the help of your BTS. Suppose the subscriber 1 is sending some data to the subscriber 2. So suppose forwarding some images, PDFs. So at that time using internet. So at that time whatever the data needed for this internet access, it is also controlled or managed with the help of your BTS. Right. Now what power is needed for this particular operation, or what is the power of the signal received by the mobile station, that power management, it is also done with the help of your BTS. So this is all about the base station system. So once we understood the base station system, then let us have a look over what exactly we mean by the base station. So it is base station system. Now I am talking about the base station. So what exactly we mean by base station, right? So as I discussed earlier, that base station is a fixed station which is not moving. So while talking about the base station, we always take the word fixed station or the non-moving station. So in mobile radio system, the base station, it is always fixed one, and which is related or used for communication between two mobile station. So suppose this is your one mobile station, right? And suppose this is your second mobile station or second subscriber is there. So if M1 and M2 are doing communication within them, so if M1 wants to call M2, so M1 is a mobile station. Similarly, M2 is also a mobile station, and the communication between M1 and M2, it is done with the help of fixed station, and that fixed station is known as base station, right? So base station, it is the fixed station. So while defining the base station, we can write as a base station is a fixed station. So base station is a fixed, in bracket I will note down, non-moving. So base station, it is a fixed non-moving station in a mobile radio system, in a mobile radio system, which communicates mobile stations. Right. So base station is a fixed non-moving station in a mobile radio communication system which communicates with your mobile stations. So this is your mobile station and this is your another mobile station. Right. Okay. So while talking about the base station, we can say that the base stations are located at the center or at the edge of coverage region. So in our previous lecture also we discussed that when we discussed the cell concept. So suppose this is your base station, right? So this particular base station, it is always located at the center of the cell or coverage area, right? So this particular base station, it is always located at the center of your coverage area, or it may be located on the edge of coverage region. So suppose this is edge of your coverage, so at that time the base station is also located at this particular, as this particular author is saying, right? Now these base stations consist of radio channels and also transmitter antenna, receiver antenna mounted on a tower. So this particular base station is having, as we previously discussed, some antenna system is over there. So this antenna system consists of a transmitter antenna as well as a receiver antenna, right? Suppose if we take the example, suppose this is your mobile station or a mobile subscriber, so M1, and this one is second mobile subscriber, suppose it is M2. Now suppose M1 want to talk with M2, so M1 send a voice signal is transmitted to the base station. Now this signal is received with the help of receiving antenna. So whatever the signal transmitted by M1 is received by receiving antenna, and then it is further transmitted to the M2. So the transmitting antenna is used. So to collect the signal from mobile station, receiving antenna we are using, and to collect the signal or to transmit the signal from base station to the next subscriber, transmitting antenna is used. So the transceiver action itself, it is done. So we can once again I will just demonstrate. So base station consists of a radio channels and also a transmitter antenna, receiver antenna mounted on the tower. Now let us have a look over the next concept, that is called as mobile station. So what exactly we mean by mobile station, right? So while talking about the mobile station, when we say that base station is non-moving, always keep in mind that the mobile stations are always moving, right? So a station in a cellular radio service intended for use while in motion at an unspecified location is called as a mobile station. So I will write down the definition over here. So a station in a cellular radio service intended for use while in motion at an unspecified location is called a mobile station, right? So your mobile station, it may be a portable handheld personal units, or this particular mobile station, it may be installed on vehicles. So for GPS tracking or that particular application, installed such a kind of mobile station are installed in mobile vehicles, right? Then the mobile station consists of user equipment and software needed for communication with mobile network. So different operating systems we are using in your mobile communication, mobile devices. So like Android is there, so such a kind of systems we are using. Now this particular mobile station, it refers to a global system connected to the mobile network. So that is mobile phones and mobile computers connected using mobile broadband adapters. Now the 2G system, 3G systems are utilizing or used for your mobile communication system. So this is all about the base station and mobile station. In our next lecture, we will discuss the further points related with your mobile communication. So meanwhile, we will stop here. So thank you. Thank you very much.